Everybody, welcome back to the Channel Fireball 5K. I am Tristan Sean Gregson here with Orie Guo. We are finally looking at Jund today, in my opinion. It's been, you're 6-0, correct?
Yeah, 6-0.
All right, so it's been a long day already. I haven't seen one of these lists yet. Let's talk a little bit about your Jund deck, why you chose to play Jund. Let's start with that.
All right, well, I chose to play this Jund deck because I feel like it has a really good matchup against Mythic, and I expected a lot of it. So, for instance, we've got our normals, like the usual specs in Jund, like Lightning, Future Leech, Spouting Through Next, and Bloodbraid Elf. But I've got four Lightning Bolts, which most of them play, but some of them don't. And I've also got four Bituminous Blasts, which I think I'm pretty unique.
You also have the two Terminates. I assume that's also for a Mythic matchup.
Yeah, Mythic, and, well, they're good against pretty much any creature, obviously.
So, I was going to say, the shell of the deck, I mean, for a long time, included Bituminous Blasts. A little while ago, they came out of what people consider to be the shell. Do you think it's a four of, it's a staple, has been good for you today?
It's definitely been great for me today, because so far I've played against Mythic today, and I played against Goblins, and it's great in both matchups, because what you really want to do is just get card advantage and kill other guys, and Bituminous Blast pretty much does both of those.
For the three people that aren't familiar with Jund, it's based on every card in the deck is a 2-for-1. Like, every card in the deck is going to give you card advantage. You're not playing blue, but you're playing a bunch of cards that are netting you card or card value. And you've really kind of brought it back to its roots with four Bituminous Blasts, and you even have Sark on the Mad. How has that guy been for you today?
Sark on the Mad's been really good. Done all kinds of things with him. Against blue-white, I made a dragon and attacked him with it. Actually, really, all he does is make a dragon.
You don't sit there and get card advantage by drawing cards with him?
Actually, one time, I was ahead on the board and didn't want to get rats, so I drew a card with him.
So you're saying you were winning anyway once, and you're like, you know what, I'll draw a card?
Well, I didn't. Well, if I made a dragon, I could have lost if he played Wrath. But
Okay. That makes sense. So, pretty much standard shell, 27 lands, which seems pretty standard right now. The 6-man lands, you're happy with that too?
Yeah, I've been happy with that. 2 Lava Claw Reaches, I think you could give or take based on preference, but definitely 4 Raging Ravine, because that card's just insane.
All right, let's moving on to the sideboard. A lot of people have been going with Sidraxis Spectre in the sideboard against Spreading Seas. I've seen you've gone the Prophetic Prism route. How has that been for you today?
Honestly, I've boarded in twice and I haven't drawn it yet.
As a 2-of, and it's only against Spreading Seas, it may or may not, although it does smooth out your mana in other circumstances.
Yeah, it's been a lot more consistent, especially when you're getting attacked by Spreading Seas and Tectonic Edge.
Meanwhile, I've seen a lot of this guy today, Cunning Spark Mage.
This guy is my number one guy. He's won me so many games. One time, a guy was a 3 and he cracked a fetch and I had 2 of them in play. Well, that happened. Another game, I've killed a lot of 0-1s, I've killed X2s when I had 2 of them in play. Basically just boarded him in every game except against Blue Light, and he's been insane.
Interesting. I wonder if in the future we'll see Cunning Spark Mage main deck in some decks, let alone Jund. Moving on, let's talk about the one Malachar Bloodwitch main, one Malachar Bloodwitch board. Why 1-1?
Honestly, I got the deck from a friend, and I like playing Miser cards, as people who know me know. And I definitely approve of this, because obviously it's great against blue-white, and the rest of the deck, we've shaved some of the good cards against blue-white, like CGN Commander, cards like Bituminous Blast. And I feel like this gives me back a little bit of percentage.
So the Goblin, let's talk about the Goblin Rune Blaster. Is that going to be good against blue-white? Is that for the mirror match? I noticed you got 4 of, so obviously you're going to want to draw it. Where is it good?
It's great in the mirror match, because you want to be trading 2-for-1, obviously. Kills the man lands. And it's also great against blue-white, because you want to be putting pressure on them while also, I guess, interfering with their plan, which is what Goblin Rune Blaster does.
So here we are at 6-0. You're 1 win away from clinching top 8 in this event. What are you afraid to play against most, and what do you want to play against most in these last 2 rounds?
Afraid of? Honestly, the deck I'm scared of most is the blue-green ramp deck. Round 1, I played against blue-green ramp and barely won. Obviously, like I said earlier, he cracked the fetch when he was a 3, and I had 2 spark mages in play, so I won that one. And then round 3, I lost game 1 in a blowout. Round 3, I played against blue-green again. Lost game 1 in a blowout, and then barely made the other 2 with spark mage.
And then what are you geared against to beat today? What is the deck you want to sit down against?
Really want to play against Mythic. And Goblins I think I'm pretty good against, which sounds like it might happen because he's doing really well.
Goblins and Mythic. Here's a Jund deck that wants to play against Mythic. That's pretty rare. But I mean, you've got the tools. You've got all the spot removal. You've got the Cunning Spark Mages in the sideboard. So this is definitely a build that is anti-Mythic. And Mythic being very popular right now looks pretty good for you, Orie.
Thanks. All right. That's really why I played it.
Good luck in the last 2 rounds. We'll see you in top 8 most likely.
I think I'd have to get really unlucky not to make top 8 at this point.
Good luck.
Yep, thanks.